Hello friends, in this video I am going to explain the procedure to draw cycloid. For that, given data is you need to draw cycloid for a 50 mm diameter circle or wheel. Okay, so 50 mm is the diameter, 25 mm is radius. Take 25 mm of radius in the rounder and draw a circle. Now divide this circle into 8 equal parts. Okay. To divide this into 8 equal parts. Okay, so in this problem we need to draw cycloid for one rotation of the wheel. So diameter of this wheel is 50 mm. In one rotation of the wheel it will cover linear distance of pi into d, that is 50 mm into 3.14, that will become 157 mm. Okay, so I'll first mark 157 mm on the line. Okay, and I will divide this 157 mm into same number of parts for which I have divided the circle. I have divided circle into 8 equal parts, so here also I will make 8 equal parts. Okay, to make exact 8 equal part, I will first make 8 equal parts on the angular line. Okay, this line can be drawn at any angle, but parts should be equal. Okay, then connect end point of this line with the end point of the our intended line, and then draw parallel lines from the other point. So now we have this 8 equal parts here on the line. Okay, also draw parallel lines from points on the circle. It's slightly slant. See, this circle is rotating and rolling in this direction, so first point of contact will be this, so here it will be what? Sorry, here it will be 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 and 8. Okay, here that is C0, the initial position of the center of the wheel. Now our intention is to get the different position of the centers for one rotation of the wheel. That is why we have divided this line into 8 equal parts. Ultimately we want these 8 equal parts on the center line. Okay, so this is C1, C2, C3, C4, okay, so now we have C1, C2, C3, and C8. Now take the radius of wheel, okay, because initial position of point P0 is the point of contact between path and circle. So take this radius, put center on C1 and draw arc on the line of 1. So here it will be P1. Remember one thing, whenever you draw the arc, it will cut here also, but the if you follow the logical sequence of the rotation of the wheel, you can simply get this. This point cannot jump directly from this to this position. It can go in this fashion. Okay. Then with the center C2, now don't change radius. It is the same radius on the line of 2. Line of 2 is this. With center C3, line of 3. With 4, it will be exactly tangential to this line. And 5, on the line of 5, 3 and 5 will share same line. 6 and 7 and finally 8. Okay, so all these points are points on of the cycloids. You can simply join these points and get the final curve. P7 and this is P8. Join these points with freehand sketch. So this is required cycloid. Thank you.